What's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Music Rocks. I'm Roxanne Avalon, and we are coming to you live today from Music Studios Los Angeles. And I have a very special guest with me today, as always. But today we have Mr. Evan Wexel.
Hello.
How are you?
Very good. It's great to
Excellent.
Be here.
Yeah. I know. I'm great. It's great to be here for me too.
Yeah, actually. I like the couch.
Thanks. Yeah. So Evan is a musician slash comedian slash singer slash songwriter.
Yeah.
Slash dad.
Yeah.
Slash dope dude, right? That's like what your official title says, right?
Yeah, and a weirdo.
And weirdo.
Yeah.
Perfect. Well, I can tell already. I just want to see. Can we get like a shot of the shirt right here?
I want to thank. Yeah. I want to thank Jake Johnson for this.
Johnson.
This was his shirt.
That's not Jack Johnson.
No, but he hates that.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't want to upset
it's
him.
It's a Facebook friend of mine. He actually opened for Bon Jovi in Nashville.
Okay.
So yeah.
That's whose shirt that was?
Yeah, it was a garage sale. His mom was having a garage sale, so I'm like, I like that shirt.
How much did you pay for it at the garage sale?
She just gave it to me.
Whoa, that's like totally destroys the whole point of the garage sale.
Yeah, you Google this, it's like $22, but
boom.
Boom.
Free.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Very thrifty.
Anyway, so you are a, well, I would say a musical comedian.
Yes.
What does that mean?
It means I'm a comedian with a guitar, not a guitarist who does comedy. Which means I'm funny.
Wait.
But I only have four chords to my name, pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah.
So less of a musician.
More of a comedian.
More of a funny dude.
Yeah, funny dude that just
can averagely play guitar.
Averagely, sub average. I'm like if I was a swimmer, I would just be learning how to do forward crawl, but I wouldn't necessarily be in the intermediate class. I would still be in
You lost me at forward crawl because I didn't even know that was the type of swimming.
I don't know. It's day camp terminology.
terrible analogy.
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about how you got started in this musical comedy.
In college, I took a class where I had to take up a new hobby. And I was in the Bon Jovi fan club, and I'm a big fan.
I'm going to stop you right there.
Yes.
I'm going to stop you right there.
Uh-huh.
Speak to me more about this Bon Jovi fan club and how you were, what your involvement was.
I was a member of backstage with John Bon Jovi back in the late 90s. Basically, all these fans would congregate at, like, for example, the Embassy Suites in, like, Secaucus, New Jersey. They'd be playing Giant Stadium. So it's basically me, two other guys, and like 300 women from all over the world, and they're named Beth or Mary Sue or Tammy Joe.
Okay.
And we're all going there to see the show. Then we come back, and I'm actually doing a sing-along with a few of the other guys, and we're doing sing-alongs at like 2 in the morning. And I got to meet John's brother, Matt, that way. I got to meet Mrs. B, his mom.
Mrs. Bon Jovi.
She got to run the fan club before his brother kind of took over it.
Oh, wow.
But so I kind of, that was like my fandom. And I was just always covering his stuff. And then a year after I graduated college, I had nothing really to do. And I had my eye on stand-up comedy. And I'm like, let me put two and two together and just take the four chord progressions I knew from covering their songs and throw in some stupid comedy and just have really weird comedy come out of it.
And see what happens.
Yeah, and it's cool to be at a show like this because, like, I got started on Long Island, New York, by just going to music venues, not even doing comedy open mics. I more did, like, wait till 2 a.m. to hear 20 emo groups shout, and then I go on and try to not get hit by something thrown at me.
Yeah, well, were people, like, expecting that if they were going to, like, a music venue to see music, and then you get up there and you're kind of, like, doing comedy? Well, how did that go?
It's so hit or miss. I mean, honestly, like, my first song, even though I don't play it anymore, is, like, it was a song about me wanting to be a male stripper. Like, that's where my head was at, like, starting comedy. Like, my next song was about me actually, like, having a baby. So that's, like, the kind of weird
place. Wow, that's, like, kind of a weird jump. You went from wanting to be a male stripper to,
like,
then having a baby.
To carrying, yeah.
Oh, because I feel like usually that's how it works. Like, you're a male stripper, and then now you have a baby.
Yeah, it's
goes hand in hand, usually.
I have the most bizarre, like, song topics. At least now I try to be current. But, yeah, I was just, when you're young, everything goes. Everything can come into play.
And you've also been on, you were on TV a few times, right?
Yeah, recently. And back, over
Tell
the years.
Tell me about your television experience.
Okay.
Everyone get ready.
Okay, a decade ago was when I was popping up on, like, the VH1 I Love the 80s and I Love the 70s and I Love Toys and E! Celebrity Feuds and all that, and which was fun. Recently, like, the past summer, they rebooted The Gong Show.
Okay, yeah,
and,
I heard about
that. And I was on The Gong Show. And I succeeded. I got the triple gong. Everyone gonged me. It's kind of like, I'm also a big wrestling fan, and when you know you're going to lose to someone, it's kind of called doing the job. So I knew going out on stage at the Gong Show, I was doing the job. I was playing the role of future Justin Bieber.
Dang, that's some heavy stuff.
And they gave me it was like the fifth incarnation of what I wanted to do on the Gong Show. But with that, I was just like, fine, I'll do this. I'll pretend I'm Bieber in the year 2067 or
okay.
He's 80 or whatever. And they were taking it. They were liking it for like 10 seconds. Then they're like, I'm over it. It's gone.
Okay, so wait. Okay, I want to talk a little bit. Can you do your the future Justin?
Future Justin Bieber.
I really, I'm a believer.
There's no,
there's no photo.
I even created a Twitter like @futurebieberew.
Wow.
So if people wanted to like see what Bieber would be tweeting about in 50 years, you can go there.
And what are some of the tweets that were featured on that?
I don't know. My hip hurts. I don't know. Just like random stuff. Like, where did I park? Stuff like that. Justin Bieber just comes out, and I'm fully tatted. I had to get my arm shaved for this.
Okay.
Fully tatted. You know, sleeveless shirt, leather, glitter hat, and I just come out, and I'm like, ah! Like bong. So
that's enough.
You can find that on YouTube.
I can't wait to see it. I can't wait to see it.
Yeah.
By the way, you guys, so as you know, we always play a fun game on Music Rock. So today, you might be wondering why we have marshmallows. Well, it's a simple reason, because we're going to be putting them in our mouth and seeing how many marshmallows we can fit in our mouth. We're not gonna start yet because I feel like I need to know a little bit more about you before we just start becoming completely like not being able to understand
before
each
we compete
other.
With each other.
Yeah, before we just get really competitive because I get competitive. You guys, all you guys watching,
it's
you
like
guys
I want those toned arms, Roxanne.
Okay. Just every day in the gym working my buys and my tries.
LA Fitness.
Yeah. LA Fitness NoHo kicks me there at 7:30 in the morning. Awkward. Not watching. You're like, I'm in the Roxanne fan club. I show up every morning and watch your workout.
We love you, Roxanne.
Not awkward at all. So tell me a little bit about some of the songs that you have recently created.
Okay.
You're telling me about some of them, and I'm excited.
Yes. The most recent thing you can get on iTunes or Amazon or Spotify, blah, 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 is a song I wrote about a New York sports talk show host named Mike Francesa, who is a man in his 60s from Long Island, but has a lot of unintentional comedy and eccentricities.
Okay.
So I kind of like took all these inside jokes about him over the past 10 years and threw it in a song. Because there's actually
like a very specific topic.
It's a very specific, but there's like he's known in like the New York area. So like New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, they know this guy Mike Francesa, and he's kind of bonkers. But he's number one in the area. Like he's number one afternoons, weekdays, and he's about to retire from the station. So there's a convention called FrancesaCon.
Whoa! Wait. This guy has his own convention just about him.
Yeah. A few years ago, these guys were like, let's just have a convention of like people just want to show up and like. Talk about Mike and just exchange like what he usually says, like New York or back after this. So, you know, just random stuff like that.
Like the things that every single like newscaster says.
Everything like everyone from New York would say. And we they all gathered in like a bar a couple years ago and they like filled out a bar and they're like, we gotta do the bigger thing than this. And like they sold t-shirts. And then the second year, they sold out Irving Plaza in New York, which is like 1,000 people.
Oh my goodness.
And I got in touch with them and I'm like, I gotta get out of this. Can I like MC? Can I do something? So I MC'd and Mike showed up. So the Mike Francesa showed up for FrancesaCon, which kind of kills the joke a little because you're kind of doing this whole convention behind his back.
So they're like, wait, who invited him? Why is he?
Because they're like, but he's showing up. So then it kind of turns into a meet and greet, which is fine. And then, like, the following year, he brought his old radio partner, which is Chris Mad Dog Russo.
Chris Mad Dog
Russo. He's called the Mad Dog. Yeah, he's been described as Donald Duck on steroids.
Whoa, I don't even know what that means, but I feel like I like it.
He's like all over the place. Like, hey, the Giants, I want one World Series. Yeah, so that's Chris Mad Dog Russo. But they joined up. They were featured on an ESPN 30 for 30 that just came out. It's like a documentary a couple weeks ago. And they showed me, actually, as the MC of the FrancesaCon, where they reunited.
Nice.
But the last FrancesaCon, 2017, I did have a song called Mike Francesa that I wrote to the tune of Hallelujah.
I would like to hear a little bit.
Okay.
I would like to hear that. I think everyone needs to hear this a little bit.
I have the Leonard Cohen version, Hallelujah, which I may not play just so I don't get sued by Leonard Cohen's estate.
Okay, that sounds good. We don't want that.
But this can be heard. I have to remember how my songs go. Please. This is a snippet of Mike Francesa as available on iTunes, blah, blah, blah. Was a man from 1 to 6, number 1 without any tricks, drank liters of Diet Coke that went right through ya. Of everyone at the Fan, no one is richer. Andy Pettit is a starting pitcher! And in the bathroom, Jay Glazer will stand next to ya. Mike Francesa, Mike Francesa, doesn't get along with the Jets, Mike Francesa. Good. That was it.
That's just five minutes of that.
He's on 5 hours a day.
Make sure you guys check out Evan Wexel. Follow him. Check out his music on iTunes, Spotify, all that good stuff. And you can hear all about Mike Francesa and the whole entire song, because there's more, believe it or not.
I found out that no one on my Facebook feed cares about this song at all. So it's good that...
We care.
I need other, the Behringer Army.
We care. Yeah. Behringer cares.
Yeah, Behringer
for
cares.
Sure.
That's good.
That's going to be our new hashtag. Hashtag Behringer cares.
Behringer cares.
Yeah.
Coddling, struggling musicians. one interview at a time.
I like that. We're going to start a charity fund or something about that.
Yeah, and then Sarah McLachlan can voice over it.
For just 25 cents a day, you can help a struggling musician. Less than a cup of coffee. And we'll just zoom into you sad with your guitar. I only know 4 chords. No.
I've had to convert to belly dancing just to make ends meet. So, yeah.
We'll save you. Okay. Anyway, all right. What do you think if we continue this interview, but we start with the game?
Do it.
You ready?
Yes.
All right. So basically the object of the game is we're just going to keep periodically, whenever we feel the need, we're just going to put marshmallows in our mouth and keep them in there.
Yeah.
You can't swallow them.
Okay.
It's a no-cal game.
This is fine.
Low-cal game.
Whenever s'mores are done at parties or back barbecues or whatever, I just go straight to the marshmallows.
How many do you think you're going to be able to fit in your mouth before no one can understand what you're saying?
7.
7? Seven? I was thinking 20 minimum.
13.
Okay, well, that's a big jump. You have no idea. You don't. You're really bad at this. All right, okay, let's go. Here we go. We'll start with 1.
Okay.
So, cheers.
Okay.
It's big.
It's big.
It's bigger than I thought it was going
to
be.
You have to chew it, or it's just we're about to get Novocaine?
I don't know. Yeah. I don't know the technique. This is the first time I've ever played this game in my whole life.
Okay.
So, maybe you can try to... I'm just going to hold it over here.
Yeah.
And,
it's like we just got in a fight before the interview. It's I want to talk about Chipotle. No, you can't.
But what I do want to talk about is your baby.
I got a kid.
Your kid.
You're
a daddy.
He's now 5.
He's 5 now.
He's more popular than me.
So he actually went viral.
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
When he was 2, we made a video.
I don't know what to do with my mouth.
That's okay. I can start lisping as well, to add an extra wrinkle.
All right.
When he was 2, I made a video where he was naming all the WWE wrestlers. Once their music came on, he could name who it was right away.
Oh, really?
So we made a video. I shared it with some people, like Stephanie McMahon, who's Vince McMahon's daughter. And
I know. I was deep into the WWE. We'll talk about that later.
Yay!
Yeah.
And they shared it. She retweeted it. And then Vince McMahon eventually tweeted it.
Whoa.
They're called the dirt sheets, the wrestling rumors pages.
Oh, okay.
They're doing you're reading these wrestling dirt sheets about Roman Reigns or Daniel Bryan. And then there's 2-year-old can name all these 20 themes in 2 minutes. So, yeah, that's...
And how old was he when he did that?
He was 2. He's a little 2. More than 2. Then I did another video where he was naming the up-and-comers, in NXT, the developmental
talent. That's past my time. I don't know.
And then I had him do one with 30 legends. So he's naming Hulk Hogan and Ultimate Warrior and Ric Flair. And then when he was 3, I had him name rock bands.
Just random. It's
harder to get traction, but you have to contact each band. And some bands actually liked it. He named Hoobastank.
So like was, the Hooba, dude, remember that?
So like, oh, man. He knew, like, running away, crawling in the dark, I think, is the one, like, Beckett was able to name.
Really?
So, yeah.
And hit, well, I'm going to go for another one.
Okay, fine. And then Little Big Shots tried to get Beckett to do that kind of gimmick, but he outgrew it. This was like a, it was a specialized thing.
So, you know what's really funny is I used to be really into wrestling myself.
Nice.
I'm admitting that, good. Like, willingly, with marshmallows in my mouth.
Well, this is the time to get back in, though.
Like Bret Michaels, Bret Hart.
Bret
the Hitman Hart.
And Shawn Michaels.
Right. But Bret Hart was my fave.
Good.
Love you, Bret Hart, if you're watching.
Good.
And, dude, I used to go to, like, the shows and used to see all the wrestlers. And
nice.
I was really into it. Whatever. It's like, we don't have to talk about it anymore.
Hart.
And you said that, so your kid's name is
Beckett Sage.
But you said there's also a wrestler now.
There's going to be a women's tournament called the Mae Young Classic in late August. On a WWE network. But, plug. but there's a wrestler named Sage Beckett.
The reverse your kid is of my Beckett kid. Sage.
Her name is Sage Beckett.
Did you copyright your kid's name before you named him that? Because I feel like you
should have. No, I mean, earlier I think her name was Sage as a first name in an earlier name for her.
Hmm.
Like she used to be Sage something else.
Yeah.
Don't know about the Beckett.
Hmm.
But we've now we've corresponded. She's like a fan.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had like a hashtag. Hashtag Beckett Sage for Sage Beckett.
Nice, I like
it. Like supporting each other.
Very cool. This is actually a clip of your kid.
Yeah.
Looking adorable.
Yeah, when he was two.
Look how cute he is.
Naming the Big Show, huh?
Ooh, it's the Big Show. See, I know that one.
Yeah.
I love it. He was so adorable.
Yeah.
And so he just knows all the wrestling. Do you guys still do the wrestling? Oh, you're going for one?
They're dissolving a little bit.
You can't eat them.
I'm not trying to eat them.
Don't eat them.
They're just dissolving.
You're cheating.
They're dissolving. It's like...
I'm going for two.
Okay, little.
I think this is like number four.
Yeah.
My mouth is already full.
Let me tell you.
I was thinking it was going to be like 20.
I feel like my tongue can get... Now it's Mike Tyson. I like this tattoo on the side of my face.
So, you guys still... I can't even like...
Yeah, it's okay. You just gotta create a little cavern, from which you can speak.
So what do you have going on now? Plug yourself now.
Now I'm promoting, my Mike Francesa song is really taking off. It's not ranked on Amazon or iTunes yet, but it'll soon get like one highlighted bar filled in of the 20.
There you go.
My gigs are coming up soon. I do a lot of colleges.
Okay.
You can see me August 18th in Memphis.
Okay.
At Christian Brothers University.
Okay.
What am I doing next after that? I don't know.
Put another marshmallow on your mouth.
Yeah, let's see. What else is my schedule? I should go to my own website. I should be on top of this.
You guys can just go to his web.
funnyevan.com.
What was it?
FunnyEvan.com.
What?
FunnyEvan.com.
Okay. Follow him. I think we're done.
At Evan Wexell.
Follow him.
Twitter, Facebook,
Instagram. Okay, we're done. Thank you guys. Thank you for joining me on Music Rock. I'm Roxanne Avalon, and I will see you guys. I'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Good job.